Umu Sangare, Sidiki Diabate, and Aya Nakamura. What do all of these huge music stars have in common? Well, they all come from grand djeli families, and the first two even consider themselves to be modern-day djelis. So, okay, what's a djeli? Well, they're kind of like a storyteller, praise singer, poet, and musician all in one. And they've influenced the likes of this woman, Aya Nakamura, the most streamed female French artist in the world. She's the daughter of a djeli and says that's what's inspired the Black Girl Magic vibe in her music. So what is it about this historic djeli thing that's influencing so many artists today? The tradition began in the 13th century Mende Empire, what is modern day Mali. It then spread all across West Africa to these six countries. Djelis were super important back then because not a lot of people could read or write. So guess who was in charge of recording all of the people's daily lives? Yep, that's right, these guys. Their main job was to keep track of the town's information, including births, deaths, marriages, wars, and all other important events. These stories would then be passed down from generation to generation. There were also entertainers of the town, playing different instruments while telling fun stories that often had hidden life lessons and morals in them. The most popular instruments that they played were the kora, similar to a harp, the balafon, similar to a xylophone, and the ngoni, kind of like a guitar. Fast forward 8 centuries later to today. There are still many modern day djelis in West Africa. They often travel from town to town performing at special occasions like weddings, wherein West African culture dictates that you must spread them the money while they serenade you, kind of like a Yoruba wedding. Now that we're all caught up, let's meet with Alim Kamara, a modern day Sierra Leonean djeli and rapper, who's honoring an ancient tradition with an international twist.
So my name is Alim Kamara. I'm a hip hop artist and storyteller, born in London, UK. And when I was young, I was sent back home to Sierra Leone, West Africa. I grew up around storytellers, griots. Griot was the French term. The storytellers would be known as djelis. And we would sit around campfires and listen to stories. And those stories taught us powerful lessons. And on my return to the UK, there were no more storytellers, or so I thought. And then I came across an art form known as hip hop.
Tell it in the booth when troops attack tribes. Bullets let loose, snatch the lives of the poor.
And essentially, for me, it became storytelling as I knew it in the village evolved with rhythm, rhyme, and music. And I fell in love with that format and adopted it and started rapping. Eventually, as time would go on, I would find myself back again in the art form of the spoken word known as storytelling. Story is an organization I created to inspire greatness and preserve the tradition of storytelling. And essentially what we do is we go around to schools and organizations using storytelling as an art form to teach young people and adults with morals and motivation and culture. We've had the opportunity now to travel with Story to Argentina, Peru, Sierra Leone, Gambia, Mexico. And what we do is we travel to tell stories, share culture. So imagine going to these countries where they've never come into close contact with somebody of an African background. So I get to share my culture with them, and the most important thing for me is changing the narrative.
And then the next day, the woman went out in the field and she was working on the farm.
What I love most about what I do is the aha moment. The aha moment is when I appear in my African attire, something that is unusual to an audience, when I automatically switch into my African accent because subconsciously this is how I grew up listening to stories. So I find that I speak differently to when I'm telling stories. It's almost like I am embodying my forefathers. And that aha moment is the time when the audience member realized this person is a reflection of me. It is such a humbling feeling to be able to know that something that I came from listening to in the village as a child that was passed down to me that has now become my tool, that has now become my passport, my ticket to take me around the world and connect with individuals and be able to say to them, you are great, and let us preserve this art. It is a powerful art